You've got serious competition in there.
You just said the magic words, Jackson. Fallon Carrington thrives on competition.
You know, there's something hot about hotel sex. Must be the change of scenery. Or the mini bar stocked with overpriced chocolates. That Blake and I are on a sabbatical. But this one is permanent. Although hotel life is getting a bit mundane. And sleep in the same bed as that Pop-Tart Ashley? No. I'd rather wear low-rise jeans to brunch. I'm gonna buy a house. And so it's something I should probably experience at least once in my life. You know, people do live alone. Savages next. Down boy, he's with me. Open houses are for peasants. Who has the time? This way, the market comes to me. Laminate flooring. This place should be condemned. Next. This virtual tour was a giant waste of real time. Oh, honey. Let's go, boys!
And look,
the visual is so impressive.
Thanks. I wasn't sure about
it. Okay, listen, that's enough with the special Queer Eye episode. I have a house to buy? Wait, who are these town and country looking newcomers, and why are they hugging that old lady? Well, I guess I'll just have to destroy a family of four.
Whoa.
All is fair in love and real estate. Do you think Esther would like an early Easter basket, maybe filled with Fabergé eggs?
Are you kidding?
You're right. Go more traditional. How about an original Picasso? I'll see if I can pull one from the Carrington vault. Mmm. Yes. I like it. I like it. Lean into the whole grandmother thing. Really play up the nostalgia. You know what? Attach it to a box of hard candies and I'm in.
He wants to sell to a family.
What? This is discrimination. We should call the ACLU. No. I'm not giving up. Not yet. Good news! I just talked to Jax. The letter to Mrs. Winslow worked. I am back in the game. Right, a personal touch with just a tiny bit of embellishment.
Your children are adorable.
Oh, Mommy's perfect little angel. She said she wanted to sell to a family. I panicked, okay? I didn't think she would actually want to meet everybody. Anyway, we're all invited over there tonight.
All of who? You don't actually have children. Fallon, we're not even married.
Well, technicalities. When Alexis and Blake would be fighting, I would just sneak over there and I would peek in the window just to get an idea of what a happy family was like. And they ate dinner together and they played charades and had movie nights and I don't know. Seeing a real family made me realize that things could be different or better. I know it sounds crazy.
No, it doesn't sound crazy. Crazy is accepting an invitation for a family you don't have.
You're right. I should go talk to her. Hi!
Fallon? Why are you driving a minivan? And what are you wearing?
Oh, I had no idea how comfortable poly blend sweaters were. But you and the two kids will.
Two kids? Oh
my God, what did you do? Did you buy two kids from someone?
What? No, don't be ridiculous. I'm renting them. You get $20 for every time you call me mommy. Okay? They could totally pass as our kids.
Our kids?
Yeah, only until escrow closes. Mrs. Winslow will just assume that you're the father. And I, of course, am the very loving mother.
Mommy!
Save it! I told you it only counts when you're in front of the old woman.
I love you, Mommy.
Oh,
it warms my heart.
Well, no, I mean, not these children, obviously. The younger one has an overbite. Well, I think we do, but one should never assume. Do we like cookies, honey? I recently found out that my husband doesn't want trees nearby. I am more than capable of taking care of a tree. Thank you very much. I mean, I might need a little help from a few gardeners, maybe even a night gardener. Why wouldn't I want trees? Everybody wants trees. She's so funny. Sweetie, I don't have any money for you. Stepfather.
You're divorced.
My first husband died in the war. It's bedtime, kids. Why don't you go to the car and Daddy and I'll meet you there.
Right. Send the kids outside alone, in the dark. Mother of the year.
You know what? I think I've had about enough of Daddy's snide comments.
You get out!
Shut up! So you were saying this house gets a lot of south-facing light?
Get the hell out of my house, you crazy bitch!
If it's a choice between you and children, I mean, Liam, I choose you.
You see, I'm all about compromise.
But I'm not backing down on the 15-bedroom thing because if it gets me. I hear one of those floozies from The Real Housewives owns this place. I swear I can smell the stench of desperation and spray tan. Oh, you know they filmed a Marvel movie here, but I'm sure the sci-fi geeks only show up for, you know, Dragon Con, Comic Con, pretty much all the cons.
Double homicide, right here. Rumor has it there's still blood under the floorboards. I heard there was a minor rodent infestation.
What?
I'm sure they won't come back.
Rodents?
Cornhouse.